So 13th was Kshetra, Kshetrajna Vibhaga Yoga, the field and the knower of the field, arguably the most technical chapter, and similar to the 8th chapter, but perhaps more technical than that. We got over it, put it behind us. 14th chapter, this is relatively downhill from here. The rest of the Gita, in fact, is relatively downhill from here. 13th chapter is kind of sort of the highest point in terms of the difficulty of understanding. From here on, we start climbing down. That assumes, climbing down assumes trust. When we climb up the hill, apne prayas se chalte, we make our own effort, we try hard. Or we pedal hard if we're biking, or we hit the pedal of the gas harder if we're driving. We can muscle up if you're running. It's mostly based on our effort trying. But once you reach the peak and we have to go down, then we have to trust the slope. We have to have faith that this road will take me, that the momentum of everything that I've accumulated thus far, it will take me. So yahan se shraddha ka mahatva shuru hota hai. Shraddha in the sense of, obviously shraddha pehle bhi hai, shraddha in the sense of believing until it fully gets in. Not blind faith, never meant blind faith in the Gita or any of the Hindu, in Vedic Shastras, never recommended blind faith. Vedas themselves, the char Ved jo hum log kehte, there's innumerable Vedas, but the four that we know and the four sub Vedas that we know, total eight, they themselves say, look, listen, you've come to this point, we cannot take you beyond this, but this is not the end. This is in the Vedas. You have got to go beyond us. There's only one religion and only one set of scriptures on this planet that asks the seeker to go beyond it, exhorts it, reminds it. This isn't it. It's it. This was all meant to condition your head and to get you up to this point to practice and to get on this path, literally in the Vedas. Majority of the Vedas are simply conditioning, getting ready. And then when the Jnana Kanda starts, which is called Aranyak. Aranya is forest, secluded place. And that's when that last cherished, treasured portion of the Vedas, the sages of the Yore, used to go to the forest to find a secluded place for quietude and sattvic environment, goodness, not a lot of clamor and clutter. And then they would read and understand, decode, explain to each other, question each other. And therefore they started to be known as Aranyak. They're also known as Brahmans, not the caste Brahman, but the one that has the potential to situate me, one, into Brahmapada, the unity consciousness. So the Vedas say, listen, this is the end of the, just say, look, we go to, what is it, North Rim, I believe. And there are other places in the US. The road doesn't go all the way through. It says you have to park here. You have to hike on your own. Get your sticks, your backpack, your water bottle. If you want to go beyond this, you have to hike on your own. This is not the peak. This is not the end. This isn't it. If you want to reach the peak. Aise hi Vedon mein kaha hai ki, okay, from here on, we've sort of led you up to this point. Now jump and see where you go, where you land, what you find. So aise hi, then you would have to trust it and keep going. Tervi adhyay tak mere anubhav mein, I'm only speaking from my experience. 13th chapter tak, सारी डिफिकल्टी है गीता समझने में समझाने में. तो 14वें अध्याय से अपने अपना सोचिए और विश्वास रखे that this is how it is. He's saying that this is how it is set. Common sense use करके, it's not a lot of brain required from here on. Just like when you're going downhill, as I was saying, there's not a lot of power needed. You can drive in neutral. You can stop pedaling and still keep going and you'll reach गंतव्य स्थान अपने. Destination ko aise hi. So with that, we had begun a couple of sections ago, 14th adhyay, which is Gunatraya Vibhag Yoga. just to impress upon your mind, just to remind you all, the first two shlokas, Param Bhuya Pravakshami, is reminding, let me emphasize, so let me remind you again, let me tell you again. Jnananam Jnanam Uttamam, this is the first line of the first verse. I'm coming back to it because these first two shlokas are very important. It's almost like every time we do the 14th chapter, these first two shlokas should be held as a reminder. Param Bhuyam Pravakshami Jnananam Jnanam Uttamam. This is the essence of all knowledge there can be, Arjun. And therefore, you may not have retained it. In the warfare, you're probably distracted. You're looking at the elephants and the horses and Duryodhan beating his chest and everything else. So hold on, I'll come back. Let me emphasize this again. Let me share with you, because this is it. If you catch these nuggets, you would reach there. Param Bhuyam Pravakshami. I had very elaborately decoded last time or the one before the significance of the word Pravakshami, like how, what kind of emphasis is implied in it. But for now, let's just say that he's saying, let me emphatically insist once again, because there's no point in knowing everything else, even if you have all the knowledge of the world. It's really no real gain if you miss this. And if you get this, there's really no need. There is no use. There's no purpose for the rest of the knowledge. It's okay if you know, and it's okay if you don't, if you understand this. So that's what the first line was. Yad jnatva munaya sarve param siddhimato gata. This is what all the munis, the thinkers of yore, have understood, have processed, have internalized. Sarve, anyone who has reached that destination has not been able to do so without understanding this, that the modes of nature, how the nature works around us, because we're compelled in it. Yeah, siddhimato gataha, ultimate, siddhi is accomplishment, achievement, final achievement. Whether we follow Maslow's theory, or Adhyatma, or any religion for that matter, I don't believe anyone anywhere, knower, seeker, any saint has said that the Param Siddhi, the final achievement, is the biggest house, or the most expensive car, or the strongest body, or any of that. Those myths have been debunked. Param Siddhi, the ultimate achievement, has to be a lot more subtler than that, spiritual than that. And so that's what he's saying. And it is so, its power is such that idam jnanam upashritya mama sadharma magataha, which is the second verse of this, first line of the second verse of this chapter. Sarge apina upajayante pralayena gathanticha. This is so powerful, Arjun, idam jnanam, this jnan, or gnan, or gyan, this comprehension, this experience is so powerful, so potent, that it will, mama sadharma magata, you will be like me. Mama is me, sadharma. Dharma is guna, is virtue, is nature, characteristic. Like the real importance of the word dharma, by the way, the dharma of fire is heat. The dharma of ice is cold. The dharma of light is brightness. The dharma of matter is weight, vajan. So that's the real meaning of dharma. Swadharme nidhanam shreya paradharma bhayavaha. We have heard this verse before in the Gita, where the reminder to Arjun was, is go back and situate, like hunker down in your own nature, swadharma. As a Chetanatama, your nature is not janma mrityu jara vyadi dukkha dosha anadarshanam. In the 13th chapter, he also says, your nature is not, your qualities are not such that you are formed and then deformed and then rot in between, and then crack, and then go bad. This, that, any of the janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi, you're diseased, and then you get grief struck, stricken, you get, become sad. None of those are your virtues. Those are concocted, those are taken on, those are absorbed onto you. You absorb from the external environment. There is no grief for you. There is no sadness for you. Because that's not your dharma. Your dharma is satchidananda. Your dharma is to remain eternally conscious and joyful. The original nature. Now, upon it, various layers have been layered. And you've taken those to be your dharma. Including the layer of the body, the layer of the breath, the layer of the sensory perception, the layer of the intellect, thinking. These are all layered, and you've taken those to be yourself. As you unpeel those layers, layers and layers, you peel off me. The pain is there, but the joy is too. Then sarge apina upajayante pralayena vyathanticha. Even in the formation of the cosmos, even while owning, forming, experiencing the entire creation, you will remain aloof from it. You will observe it, witness it, watch it, enjoy it, but not become of it. Pralayena vithanti, even at the time of annihilation, complete destruction, you will remain the observer, and not, there will be no connection with misery or grief or anxiety of any sort, let alone these little, small little anxieties of on a day-to-day basis. The biggest fear will not move you. So ye pehle do shlok the yahan ke, which then drew Arjuna's attention. So what is that external environment then? That what creates those layers? How do I get layered upon layer? He said, well, so let me just broadly categorize those into three. Sattva, Raja, Tam. It is a continuous nature. The nature is not of three different kinds. It is still continuous, but it has three variations, three gradations, if you, three layers, three strata, as if. And depending on where you are, you'll absorb that. If a magnet is sitting somewhere, and there are metal pieces around it, there is iron, and there's brass and gold and silver and everything, all the others, aluminum. Only the iron ones will get attracted to it. The magnet is formed of iron. Magnet is nothing but super compressed iron. It'll get attracted to itself. That's the key. It'll get attracted towards itself, more powerful of that nature towards the magnet. All the rest of the metals will sit around there. As he chal raha, pankhe chal raha, if the fan is blowing, those that are lightweight will start blowing. Halka halka jo hai. Those that have some gravity, it will not bother them. You can increase the speed of the fan as much as you want, but it will not bother the paperweight or the phone or the key or the watch on the table. The fan will not blow because it has its own gravity. The fan is the same, blowing the same air for the piece of the paper and the feather and the thread and the watch and the phone. Some are blowing and others are not. Some are established in their gravity, others are not. The magnet is still the same, and there's different kinds of metals. Within one kind is getting attracted towards it, others are not. And so, and the glory of human life is we can, through our own consciousness, through our own sadhana, through our own effort, we can actually understand this and realize that we have the power. How much gravity do I want? Do I want to be moved? Do I care to be moved by this fan blowing? Do I want to be attracted to this magnet? Or do I want to stay in? We're not forced. We, the real us, so this is where a consistent study of the Gita will be necessary. When it is downhill only if we're now situated in who we really are. 13th chapter should have fully clearly established that we're the witness, we're the observer, we're the sakshi, and we're not the body, we're the driver in the car, we're not the car, so to speak. And so when I say I or we, now I'm talking about our real nature. We absolutely do not have to be blown by the fan or be drawn to the magnet or be burned by the fire or any other, because we are not of this, we're not material in any sense. So we do not have to be, and this is really possible, we do not have to be disturbed and bothered and concerned by the circumstances around us. There is, with practice, there is still a way to remain the same self throughout. And so we'll see the different descriptions of those. With all that context of what we've done through until now, I think we've covered five shlok ho gaye the. Hey Arjun, sattva gun, rajagun aur tamogun ye prakriti se utpanna tino gun avinashi jivatma ko sharir mein bandhte hai. So we'll pick up from 6. हे निष्पाप उन तीनों गुणों में सत्व गुण तो निर्मल होने के कारण प्रकाश करने वाला और विकार रहित है वह सुख के संबंध से और ज्ञान के संबंध से अर्थात अभिमान से बांधता है. So helping us understand what these three divisions are like, what these three gradations, what these variations are like, because if we can understand them, then we can decide where do I want to be, which way, which one of these three, if I must pick one, which one of the three do I want to be attracted to? Do I want to be drawn to? Well, we'll have to know what they have, what they bring, what they do, what their effect is, what their qualities are. If we understand the nuances of it, then we can decide. And we can decide. You will see that we can decide. In fact, we, for the most part, we do decide. A lot of times when we are unaware, we get drawn wherever the wind blows. It just takes us. If the conditioning, if the vatavaran, if we're doing dandiya and everyone is dressed up and there's lots of food and lots of pataki and everybody's chit-chatting, talking, and if we're unaware of ourselves and slip for that moment, we've now become the body, the human, the man or the woman again. And suddenly we start jumping, dancing, chit-chatting, eating, joking, kicking and screaming and all of that. And the moment we become aware, we become the witness. It doesn't bother us. We don't hate it. We're still there. Panki ki hawa phir bhi chal rahi hai, lekin wo apni jagah pe baitha hua hai. Phir usko vajan aa gaya. Jaise jaise chitta mein awareness aa gaya. The key in spiritual practices, the biggest key, the greatest virtue is awareness. Dhyan mein rehna. Remembering. Isi ko simran ka, remembrance ka. Sabse badi sadhana ka, remembering, remembrance, simran. Whichever way, naam likh koi kisi ko naam likhe, Bhagwan ka naam likhe, yaad rehta hai, oh yeah, that's right, oh yeah, Krishna is mine, I'm Krishna's. I don't have to worry. Kisi ko mantra jab ke hota hai, some anchor to around like, this is my railing, this mantra is my railing, I'm not going to slip, I'm not going to get angry, I'm not going to salivate. The moment I see something that I like, this, I'm holding on to my railing, I'm not going to slip. What's that railing? It's my mantra. Or it's the remembrance of God that, no, he'll protect me. He'll not let me. Whatever it takes. Or once and for all, jumping such that through Gyan, you have realized that the heck with all, I am just totally not any of this and I have nothing to do with it. I am here and I'm going to make the best of it. I'm here to beautify the dream. I am not going to curse anyone. I'm not going to kick anyone. I'm not going to hate anyone. There is no place for negativity in me because I am steeped in goodness. Not even steeped in goodness. That would imply that goodness is different from me. I am. Goodness is steeped in me to become good. Where is the question of fear or anger or cursing or hating anything? But like oil from water, I will always remain aloof and different from it internally. So it is possible, but for that, it's important to understand who does what of these three. Where do I, which corner? So last time, since Richa, Didi, and Sanjeevai wasn't there, I had given an example. Ashwinibai was there, and I remember your question well. If there is time, we can either take that up today, or I can separately call you and we can discuss that. The question was first, what forces us? Last time, Ashwini Bhai, towards the end of it, had asked, like, what compels us? Why do we get dragged into it? How come? Like, do we not have any choice? I'm adding sub questions to it. Don't we have any choice? We, you know, I understand it. I get it. I read it. I heard it. I know it. But some force, something still pushes me. What is it? How can I, and not more than what is it, how can I combat it? How can I get rid of it, or how can I protect myself from it, was the question. And the answer to the question is like, is the sort of, it pervades the Gita. It starts with the third chapter. And actually, I might even say it starts with the second chapter. It starts with your own, with your real identity. It starts with the principles of Karma Yoga. I think I had suggested 30th verse in the third chapter. Karma Yoga, Tisra Adhyaya, Tiswa Shlok. Mai Sarvani Karmani Sanyasya Adhyatma Chetasa Nirashir Nirmamo Bhutva Yuddhasva Vigata Jvara. If you anchor around the 30th verse of the third chapter and go back five shlokas and go forward five shlokas, 10 or 11 verses, a lot of the answer to the question, like, I have to live within this environment and these gunas are forcing me to act bad or get angry or be greedy, or I am looking at thinking of eating what I don't want to. Why is this happening? Why can I not control my mind? And if so, then what can I do? How should I do what I have to do? Part of the answer is in that section of the third chapter. Part of it is a little bit is in the fourth chapter, and then there's also in the fifth chapter, it starts to cumulatively build up. So we would have to bring all of that learning and distill it as an essence when we get to that question, answering that. But the answers are very definitely there in the Gita itself. There's really no need. There isn't any need to go any place to answer all of life's important questions. Gita does not tell us what's the capital of whom and what's the currency where, and all that. These are formed today and they'll go away tomorrow. This is all matter. Gita relates to the spirit because we are the spirit. It'd be useless. It would be like anything else, any other book, if all it talked about is matter. In the first chapter, it rips through it and puts it away, shreds it, throws it in the trash. Pahle adhyay mein. Woh hai hi nahi tu. Jiske liye ro raha hai, jo samajh raha hai, kuch nahi usme se, sab, everything is wrong completely. Now, therefore, let's start with the ABCs and the 1, 2, 3s. Then who am I? What am I? What is all this? So for the benefit of, again, going back to where I was going, last time I udaharan jo diya tha, jisse ye prashna nirman hua tha, and I think that both of you have heard this example before in various sessions now, but just as a reminder, it's very pertinent for this chapter. Imagine a glass chamber, like a glass room, whatever size you want to imagine, 20 by 20 by 20, 15 by 15, 10 by 10, whatever. 10 feet high, 10 feet long, 10 feet broad, like a glass cube, big. And let's see if you're watching from outside it, what's happening inside. Let's say there is a fan on the floor that's blowing air upward. Whatever you release there, some feather, a piece of thread or paper, whatever comes, it's just so powerful that it just blows up if it comes in its trajectory. That's good, except there's also a fan from above. It is also equally powerful. Whatever comes in its trajectory, it just pushes down. That's all it does. Whatever it is, it doesn't matter. It suppresses, depresses, pushes down, controls. One is pushing up, one is pulling out. Well, the laws of physics would have it. It's probably tang raha hai kahin pe, hanging somewhere. Okay, well, but that's bad. It's neither going up nor down, except it's even worse. There's also a fan, like a table fan, that is blowing same forceful air sideways. It's not blowing up, it's not blowing down, it's just blowing sideways. Now, it is not allowing that piece of thread, cloth, paper, feather to remain at one place restful at all. It's just sometimes going up, sometimes going down, sometimes here, there. Again, depending on, it's like very clear, depending on the laws of physics, the vectors and the forces, it's getting tossed and turned. Kabhi ye kone mein, kabhi wo kone mein. Sometimes we act good. Sometimes we're very quiet. Sometimes we're very tolerant. Sometimes we're very loving, very kind. All of it. Sometimes we're just like, God, I don't know what the devil got in me. Ekdam gali galoch, maar dor, chillana, chakana. Sometimes we're very controlled and self-restrained. Sattvik ahar, sattvik vyavahar. And sometimes we're just like, oh God, I so did not want to see that rubbish movie, which just wasted my 3 hours. And I filled my head with trash that it'll take me a few days to meditate to get it out of my head. Or sometimes we feel like, you know, I have so much, I have enough. I could retire, I could be financially free. I could have enough to fill the belly, this my belly and the two or three bellies that depend on me. Clothes are plentiful. The house will carry on until I'm alive. I guess I can devote the rest of my life to the param siddhi, the final achievement, the ultimate thing. And then the next thing, the next LinkedIn jobs or the next posting or next some news comes up. Well, maybe I should just try one more or this or that. So this or that, different. One more and more and more. So either more, different is that other, that fan, the sideways fan. It's known as Rajas. Rajasik vritti, Raja, the word Raja comes from it. Rajas are growth oriented. No Kshatriya, no Raja. In fact, Vaishyas also, they fall in the same class. Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, they're not happy. They're not satisfied with what they have, with that status quo. They want to grow their business, grow their company, get a bigger house, get another car, grow their clan, more of us here in this land or whatever, grow their kingdom, grow their name, their fame, their money, all that, grow, and of different kinds within that. Rajasitta mein jo hote hai, sattvikta is of the mindset, this is the fan that is lifting up, uplifting. Hey, this is enough now. I've been just stuck at the bottom, the crowd of the bottom. I need to rise above. I need to get a higher perspective, look around and understand what's what. I've been that frog in the well who always thought, oh, look how big I am. Wo menda tha na kuwe mein, idhar se udhar kudta tha. Aur bahut bahadur ho gaya tha, uski chhati phul gayi thi. Main bada menduk aur sab mendukon ka sardar ban gaya. There's none like me. I can jump from one end of the well to the other end. Who is bigger than me? And then someday, another mendak was dropped in that. He said, well, who are you? Where have you come from? He said, bad fortune. What is this? I came from the Atlantic, the Pacific. What is that? It's the ocean. What is that? It's an immense body of water. How immense? There's no telling. Like, still tell me this puffed up frog is like, tell me, how big is that? Your ocean. This is 4 or 5 feet. Is your ocean 6 feet, 8 feet, 10 feet? Maybe I can surpass that also. I'm telling you, whatever your well is cannot be insurpassable for me. And the guy said, dude, you have no idea what an ocean is. You've been all your life, you've been stuck in this well, thinking yourself that I'm so big and I'm so powerful. You have no idea what else is out there. Aisi jo hamari gati hai jeevan mein, ye do char bachche apne, do char maa baap, apni putli maas, hadde maas ki, apna, wohi, phir Diwali aya, Dasara aya, aarti kira, wo, apna baal safed kiye, mehndi lagaya, khaya piya, utna hi koop mandak, utni madke mein, utne koop mein, kuwe mein, well, mein idhar se idhar dekho, apna achche sab theek ho gaya, apna portfolio theek hai. No idea what else is out there. Sarge apina upajayante pralayena vyathanticha. Dusre adhyay ke abhi ke 14 adhyay ke dusre adhyay, dusre shlok ke dusre pankti mein abhi humne suna. It's insurpassable. Yam labdhva cha param labham manyate nadikam tata. छठे अध्याय में आत्मसंयम योग में आया था। वो हो इतना बड़ा लाभ कि इससे बड़ा और तो इमेजिन नहीं कर सकते। ऐसा यस्मिन स्थितो न दुखेन गुरुनाम अपि विचालेत, unimaginable misery, even if crashed down on your head, you would be still same unperturbed, undisturbed. That is the state of mind, Arjun, that the yogi achieves. Tasma the yogi bhava Arjuna. Therefore, Arjun, don't worry, sweat the small stuff. You must become a yogi. That is the greatest, that is the best benefit. If you trust me, if you take my name, Krishna is saying, if you have come into me, seventh chapter, he says, Nyan vidnyanyo, jnani bhyopi mato adhika. This was the last of the sixth, and then in the seventh, he says that jnani of the four kinds is the superior of all. He has finally come unto me. You cannot be shortchanged from here. You cannot return from Krishna and Gita if you commit to it through dhyan. Poor again. A dependent again, it's impossible. You cannot, you should not, you will not return from here again, looking for something, seeking something, wanting something, wondering about something, questioning anything. This is where it all ends. This is just a dead end, or then a dead end. It was a life end. This is where the life begins. This is a life end in the sense that ये डेड एंड तक आके यहां से लाइफ का प्रारंभ होता है। यू लिव इफ यू लव, यू डेड इफ यू डोंट। सीधी सी बात है। लव ऑफ गॉड इन एवरीवन, लव फॉर एवरीवन थ्रू लव ऑफ गॉड, यू लिव इफ यू लव। सीधी बात है। इफ यू डोंट, You're dead. ये बाकी शरीर चल रहा है, खा पी हो रहा है, शरीर भी तो मर रहा है ना, शरीर तो मरता ही तो है। विज्ञान की दृष्टि से देखो, जीव शास्त्र बायोलॉजिकली, एवरी सेल इज़न इट डाइंग, हाउ फ्रीक्वेंटली, एवरी मोमेंट, एवरी व्हाटएवर मिनट सेकंड, रिप्लेनिशिंग इटसेल्फ, द होल थिंग इज डाइंग एंड रिप्लेनिशिंग। वर सेइंग आई एम लिविंग, नो लाइक आई एम, हाउ मेनी टाइम्स आई हैव डाइड ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटली इफ I think of myself as the body. इसका उपयोग करना है प्रेम के लिए, सबसे बड़ा उपयोग ना? तो and so that's the rajasic fan, sattvic fan was lifting up, thinking इसका ये सब वर्णन आएगा अभी ये श्लोकों में, प्रकाश लगेगी, oh my, finally I'm starting to see, starting to think, starting to realize, starting to process, internalize, contemplate, quiet down, content with what I have, not wasting my life energy in wanting to have more or more and more objects, physical matter, to satisfy the physical matter. I'm saying, okay, you guys, you dog, my body, you got enough bone there to last you until you live. I, separate, remember 13th chapter, am going to sit in a different room and do something different, okay? You got enough to eat. You got your kennel. You got your other dogs to bark at. You got a big enough ground to pee around. Whatever you want to knock yourself out, leave me alone. I am going to rise above and do. I'm going to figure out where I'm come from, who I am. ये सत्व गुण का शांत करता है, प्रकाश लाता है जीवन में. इसलिए uplifting, उत्थान करने, ऊपर उठाने वाला, taking us to the higher. परस्पेक्टिव, जितना जितना पहाड़ के ऊपर चढ़े उतना उतना नीचे देखे तो ज्यादा अदृश्य दिखे, द एंगल ऑफ विजन, द पेरिफेरल ऑफ विजन हैज इंक्रीज्ड, पेरिफेरी हैज इंक्रीज्ड, और उतना उतना क्लियरली दिख पाया। जितना पहाड़ के फुट हिल्स पे हो तो उस सामने वाला पहाड़ है कुछ, खाली इतना दिखे बस, उसके अराउंड और कुछ नहीं दिख पाया, और जो पीक पे है वो सारा का सारा देख पाए वैसे, इसलिए ऊपर उठाता है। और तामसिकता क्या करे, ऊपर से जो भी ऊपर आ रहा हो, जो भी हो, सो दबाने का कारण उधर ही बैठा, जड़ बनाए, इनर्ट बनाए, डोरमेंट बनाए, बुद्धू बनाए, बेवकूफ बनाए, इडियट बनाए, डाम बनाए तामसिक, क्यों फिर से दबा के चिपक के नीचे उठने ही नहीं दे रहा, अंधकार अज्ञान वेस्टफुल इग्नोरेंट नेग्लिजेंट ये सारे गुण तामसिकता में आ गए। जो भी नेग्लिजेंट है इग्नोरेंट है डिसरिगार्डिंग है वेस्टफुल है इनर्ट है डल है मोमेंटम नहीं जिसमें खाली लेथार्जिक है ठीक है जैसा जो कुछ कुछ इनएक्टिव है वो सब कुछ प्रयास नहीं करा कुछ वो तामसिक है उस तो लेकिन जरूरत तो है तामसिक अगर बैठा रहे नीचे जमीन पे भूख लगेगी तो क्या फिर कहां से लाना मेहनत नहीं करनी आई डोंट वांट टू गो टू जॉब आई डोंट वांट टू जॉब आई डोंट वांट टू वर्क हार्ड एट आवर्स हु वांट्स टू वर्क एट आवर्स आई जस्ट वांट टू स्लीप अराउंड बट व्हेन व्हाट विल यू डू व्हेन यू गेट हंग्री maybe my folks will have something in the refrigerator. Maybe I'll borrow from someone. Will you return? No, I don't have to return. Beg, borrow, or steal for sustenance. Tamasik kya agar bhik mangega? De do. Haddi maa, sab theek dikh raha hai, kaam kar sakta hai. McDonald's mein jaake nahi bas kya apne mil jata hai bhik mang ke mil jata hai. Kyu karna kaam? Tamasikta. Nahi to borrow. I promise. I'll give it back to you. I promise. Credit card. Here's my credit card. This is my credit card. Credit. Compel, I must buy, I must have. I don't have my own because I don't want to work hard, but I need it. Therefore, I will borrow because I'm ashamed to beg. Okay, borrow. Jab borrow bhi nahi ho raha, beg bhi nahi ho raha, to phir steal kar. He's not watching. No one knows. No one's looking. Pocket it. Utne se nahi hoga, to phir dakaiti dalo. Decoy it. गुंडा बनो लूटो माफिया बनो मारो हिंसा करो कंट्रोल करो अनार्की पूरे सत्ताधीश बन जाओ हायर एंड हायर लेवल ऑफ बिकॉज दे आर गोइंग डाउन लोअर एंड लोअर द नीड इज इंक्रीजिंग थ्रू इग्नोरेंस एंड द रिसोर्सेज आर डिक्रीजिंग थ्रू इनएक्टिविटी एंड कमिटमेंट एंड सो द गैप बिटवीन द नीड And the resources is ever widening. The aur andhakar aur darkness, tamasikta ka. Uske ulta satvikta mein ho raha, exactly. Needs are limiting, decreasing. I don't need that much. This is enough. This is good. This color is fine. This pattern is okay. I don't have to have flowers on that. One flower is okay for God. I don't have to grow the garden. All in the name of Allah, all in the name of God. भगवान के लिए लगाने बहुत मेहनत बहुत शरीर थक गया सो गए भगवान के लिए समय ही नहीं है लेकिन भगवान के लिए बगीचा लगाया भगवान ने तो कहा नवेद्या में पत्रम पुष्पम फलम तोयम यो मे भक्त्या प्रयच्छति तदहम भक्ति उपरितम अश्नामि प्रयतात्मनः एक पत्ता दे दे एक पत्ता वन लीफ एक फूल कौन से भी कलर का फूल दे कहीं नहीं बोला इस कलर का उस कलर का फूल नहीं तो फल लगा होगा घर में लाया होगा फल अथवा अच्छा तीनों नहीं तो पानी तो हम पानी दे दे क्यों में भक्त है लेकिन भक्ति से दे भावना से दे दिल लगा के दे जोड़ के दे इन अदर वर्ड बैक टू इट प्रेम से दे वस्तु तो अपन खा ले प्रसाद पेड़ा रखा भगवान के सामने के सारे पेड़े तो अपन ने खा लिए पेड़ा तो भगवान ने नहीं उठाया उसमें जो भावना डाली थी वो उसने ग्रहण करी कुछ भावना ही नहीं डाली खाली ऐसा ही पेड़ रखे ओम प्राण स्वाहा पान स्वाहा समाना स्वाहा स्वाहा पद्य पानी समर्पया भी कर करके करा तो भावना कुछ भी नहीं है मन में तो कुछ भी नहीं दिया भगवान को क्योंकि जो दिया था वो तो खुद ने खा लिया पेड़ा भावो ही भक्ति नारद जी ने कहा भगवान भाव का ग्रहण कर भावग्राही भगवान भावना लेते तो भावना ही नहीं डाली तो कुछ भी नहीं दिया सात्विक भावना डाली मेरेपन अपनेपना की भावना डाली क्षमा करना मेरे बनना नहीं घर में नहीं है जैसे तो वो ग्रहण किया सो बिकॉज इज दैवी है ना स्पिरिचुअल है ये तो मैटर है ये मैटर की बॉडी मैटर का पेड़ा मैटर की मूर्ति के सामने रख के मैटर का पानी घुमा के दे रही है और न वो मैटर है न हम मैटर है हम तो प्रेम स्वरूप है सटल है और वो भी वो है हम उससे आए हुए मम एव अंशो जीवलोके जीवभूत सनातन 15वां अध्याय पुरुषोत्तम योग You are a part of me. You are connected with me. You are me. Aham Atma Guda Kesha Sarva Bhutashaya Sthita. 10th chapter. Arjun puchhe tere ko dekhu ka tu hai kahan? Where are you? Is this it? Two hands, 2 feet standing in front of me. And you're saying I'm everywhere. Where? What do you mean everywhere? So, okay, let me tell you that. And he starts the dissertation of that in the 10th chapter. We've covered this. Vibhuti Yoga. First thing he says, Aham Atma Guda Kesha Sarva Bhuta Ashaya. Essence, andar, core, sabke andar ka core jo hai, ashay jo hai, essence jo hai, atma wo main hu. To wo to jad padartha nahi hai bhagwan aur hum bhi jad padartha nahi hai ishwar ansh jeev avinashi chetan amal sahaj sukha rashi ramayan tulsidas tulsi ramayan ramcharitmanas everywhere whichever scripture we are not material, we're matter, we're spiritual, we're spirit, so, and so is he. So, ye pede barfi ye thi ek yaad dilane ke liye, reminding us only meant as an icon, as a symbol to remind us, oh yeah, that's right, I'm keeping this in front of him. But neither that nor this is it. It's what's inside and what's inside me, inside him, and what is preserving this is that is ever connected, that is always one, and the remembrance of that is that. Subhavna se. So, isliye sattvik ulta kaam kare, upar uthane ka kaam karega, sattvik pravruti mein, jo bhi vataharan uske andar, phir bhi apni akal se, apne dimag se, apne yukti se, apne nigrah se, apne taakad se, apne dhairya se, swabhavo vijayate shauryam. The conquest of the mind is the greatest conquest. Uddhav, Narajan. This was in Uddhava Gita, also said Krishna, like into someone who was far dearer to him than Arjun. Uddhava, far, far superior than Arjun. Uddhava, much, 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 much intimately closer to him than Arjun, which was Uddhava. Very different level of relationship between Krishna and Uddhava than Krishna and Arjun, although both are wonderful, which is fabulous, spiritual. He says, ki, so, swabhav ko jeetna apne. Par jo bhi, jaise bhi paristhiti ho, usme rehte hue, making this choice that I have this enough, the remaining, I must siphon, I must recycle, I must conserve, I must preserve, I must be smart about its usage. To wo upar upar uthayega, to alag alag reality dikhegi ki, oh God, what was all this? Where was I stuck for all this time? और राजसिकता का तो मैंने पहले बता ही दिया मोर 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 डिफरेंट 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 एंड मोर मोर एंड डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मोर सो ये तीन प्रकार की हवाएं चल रही है भगवान कहते हैं सो टू स्पीक इन दिस लास्ट चेंबर देयर इज विंड ब्लोइंग अर्जुन एंड दैट्स प्रकृति इन इट इफ यू वॉच केयरफुली इफ यू आर डिसर्निंग इफ यू आर स्टूडियस इफ यू आर स्मार्ट इफ यू आर कमिटेड सूक्ष्म दृष्टि से देखेगा तो यू सी थ्री डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रीम्स ऑफ विंड्स ब्लोइंग नॉर्मली इट विल अपीयर लाइक दिस विंड्स ब्लोइंग प्रकृति में चलते रहता है आया लोग कहते हैं होता है होते रहता है कोई बात नहीं ठीक है सब ठीक है चलता है चलता है चलो आगे कोई बात नहीं बाद में कर लेंगे बाद में मिल जाएगा और ठीक है ना हो जाएगा बस ये चल रही है हवा है बाद में कर लेंगे बाद में कर लेंगे बाद में कर लेंगे होता है हो जाता है होता है ठीक है हवा इन जनरल हवा चल रही है कुछ नहीं ये तो चलता है ऊपर ज्यादा नीचे आता है व्हाट गोज अप मस्ट फॉल डाउन दिस है क्योंकि हवाएं चल रही है इधर ही में भेजा अपनी खोपड़ी इतने में ही अटक गई इसके आगे जाने का कोई प्रश्न ही नहीं बस ये सब मान लिए इतना ही दिस पाथ इज नॉट फॉर द रेस्टफुल गीता योग इज द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट पाथ द फास्टेस्ट एंड द मोस्ट गारंटीड पाथ बट इट ऑल्सो डिमांड्स द मोस्ट रेस्टलेस हार्ट And no, I will not settle for this much. This cannot be until I experience it, until I understand it, until I figure it, until I have it, I will not. This path requires the most demanding kind of seeker. The most demanding, the most audacious, the most bodacious, the wildest, uncontrolled, unrestrained, nothing but this, the most uncompromising. But it is the quickest, fastest, swiftest, joyous and the most assured path. So इसमें ये नहीं चलेगा, ठीक है ना यार, चलता है ना, वो तो हो जाता है, कोई बात नहीं, कर लेंगे बाद में. What the hell do you mean by कोई बात नहीं, कैसे कैसे बात नहीं, what, क्या हो क्या रहा है, ये. No, you have to rip through it. I will not tolerate compromise. No compromising. So with that attitude, if you watch this, you will notice three streams. Once you start understanding, you can only control that which you understand. And if you understand something, there is probably a way to control it also. Purushartha agar ho, prayas agar ho, effort agar ho to. Lekin samajhna to padega. To dikhai denge ye teen prakar ke invisible fans dikhai denge, teen streams of wind dikhai denge. And then all these shreds of threads and paper and feathers is just blowing mercilessly here and there. Now you might be able to watch some intelligent ones alongside the wall, figuring out their way, their path, on the ceiling, going on watchful, careful, thoughtful, very careful, only indulging as much as थोड़ा भी पंखे के नीचे ज्यादा लेने आगे तो फटाक से नीचे गिरा देगा. That's where the restraint, that's where the sadhana, that's where the tapasya, that's where the rest of the chapters come in. The sixth chapter in particular comes in, how to guard, how to watch. If you do that, you will see that there are paths. You know, wind patterns may be science, maybe the eye of the hurricane, for example. Itana tufan chal raha, 120, 150 miles. How come the eye is stable? It's calm. There is always still pockets. There are always still pathways. There are always still channels. Australia, jaane wali Great Barrier Reef. Whoosh, right? The forces of nature always create different patterns in it. There are ways to escape, but we have to be discerning. We have to be committed to get to it. And we have to be hard-lined on that. No, I will not compromise on my meditation. I will not sleep without doing dhyan. I will not indulge in work and the ways of the world before my morning meditation. Or if I become restless during work, in the middle of the day, I'll just stop the madness and just sit down for my dhyan. Not sure if you've tried it. I have, and I would never live without it. There is nothing anymore that can control my state of mind, because I have now found, and it is ultimately meant to even get rid of that. Like I said at the beginning of this session, that even that is dependency. If I'm dependent, oh, pehle to ek baar bhi dhyan nahi karte the, ab teen baar karna pad raha hai, to abhi to aur band gaye. Now through that, when it becomes a steady state of mind, it pervades, it percolates the entire day. Every moment is meditative. That this whirlwind is going on, but the eye of the hurricane is situated. It's moving with Ashwini Bhai. The eye of the hurricane moves with the hurricane. It does not resist the hurricane. Last time I had said, Kabira khada bazaar mein, sab ki mange khair. Na kisi se dosati, na kisi se bair. Kisi se jhanjat mein nahi, kisi wo dabbe mein samjha nahi raha kisi ko. Aray, upar mat jao, niche mat jao, idhar se udhar jao. Bhaiya, किसी को नहीं समझा पाओगे, हमारे तो ये अपने खुद को नहीं समझा पाए जब तक हम अपने आप को. कैसे समझेगा कोई हमसे? सारा पुरुषार्थ इसलिए है कि अपने आप को समझाने के लिए. और जो एक अपने आप जो एक बार समझा लिया है, तो हो सकता है उस रोल मॉडल से, वो देख के, उदाहरण से, उस आचरण से धीरे 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 किसी और पर प्रभाव हो जाए. So, सबके साथ दोस्ती रखनी है, सबके साथ शांत भाव से रहना है. किसी को विरोध वैर, किसी को सुधारना नहीं है, किसी को बिगड़ना तो है ही नहीं है. बिगाड़ेगा तो राक्षस असुर हो जाएगा किसी को, शांत भाव में रह करके. बट यू हैव टू स्टे स्टेडफास्ट इन योर ओन पाथ. वंस यू कैच दैट विंड. वो ऑस्ट्रेलिया के नजदीक वो पैसिफिक ओशन की वो ग्रेट बैरियर रीच होती है, उसमें से वो नीमो में बताया था, नीमो मूवी देखना बच्चों का. उसमें वो इतना तेजी से जाता प्रवाह किसी विशेष समय में कि उसमें जो फंस गया, पकड़ गया, कैसे करके जटा के उधर जाने जैप हो जाता है वैसे ऐसे वी हैव टू फाइंड आवर ओन पाथवे इन दिस टू राइज हायर एंड हायर ऑब्वियसली देयर इज आई एम नॉट आंसरिंग योर क्वेश्चन राइट नाउ दैट आई वाज जस्ट शेयरिंग विद यू दैट ये झंझट की कोई जरूरत ही नहीं है देयर इज नो ऑब्लिगेशन ऑन यू भगवान से कोई जिम्मेदारी नहीं है कि अरे इनको तुमको सुधारना है इनको बिगड़ने नहीं देना है इनको सिखाना है इनको समझाना है एक ही जिम्मेदारी अपन अपनी आत्मनो मोक्षार्थम पहला उपनिषदों में आता है फिर जगत हिताय च स्वामी विवेकानंद ने जो प्रसिद्ध कराया था पहले एक ही काम अपना मोक्ष प्राप्त करे अपनी छुट्टी करे लिबरेटिंग दिस सोल फ्रॉम द मिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन विथ मैटर Once you're fully disidentified, once you're fully untangled from the matter conception, that's moksha. That's mukti, because then you're no longer dependent. Jab tak hum matter hai, so long as we're envious, so long as we're jealous, so long as we're desirous, so long as we have this wish or that wish, we need society to be around us. Are you jealous of whom? Sudharna kisko hai? We need this society, which means we're dependent. With those feelings and harbored in our heart, we're increasing our dependency because we need the society around us, and therefore, unbeknownst to us, indirectly, we're becoming more and more dependent on society with all these virtues. We don't want to be, we don't have to be any of that. To idhar kaha ki dekh ye hai nishpa. हे निष्पाप उन तीनों गुणों में सत्व गुण तो निर्मल होने के कारण प्रकाश करने वाला और विकार रहित है वह सुख के संबंध से और ज्ञान के संबंध से अर्थात अभिमान से बांधता है सो इन अ वे ही सेइंग लुक अर्जुन डू यू सी दैट स्ट्रीम दैट इन इट दैट बीम ऑफ लाइट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम अबव फॉर एग्जांपल जैसे कभी खिड़की से आपने देखा खिड़की से कोई प्रकाश किरण आता है तो इसमें वो छोटे 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 कीड़े दिखाई देने लगते हैं जर्म्स अथवा डस्ट पार्टिकल्स When a beam of light is coming through the window, they were there before. Now you see the thousands of particles in a room, in our air, because they've been lit. As a this, the quality of sattvikta, when we're able to content our mind, when we're able to be happy with whatever we have, not even happy, just satisfied with what we have. Santushta satatam yogi, 12th chapter, Bhakti Yoga, Yatatma Dhrida Nishchaya. Mai arpit mano buddhir yo mad bhakta samay priya. The real yogi is santushta satat. Sama tushta. Tushta is fulfilled. Sama is always, ever, same, first class. Always fulfilled. Never half filled. Always fulfilled. Satatam yogi, right? So, it says that this sattvikta will enlighten you. The more sattvic you become, the more light you will see. The more light you will see, the more clearly you will see. Otherwise, वो वस्तु वो germs वो तो सब उधर ही थे लेकिन जब अंधेकार अंधेरे में दिखाई नहीं दे रहे थे वो वस्तु उधर ही पड़ी लेकिन अंधार अंधकार है तो समझ रहा नहीं किधर है कुछ है भी नहीं नहीं है कुछ नहीं है है सब है जैसा का वैसा है सुबह देखेंगे तो सब कुछ है ब्रह्मांड है रात के अंधेरे में कुछ नहीं है ये कैसा चमत्कार है द ऑब्जेक्ट्स द मैटर्स are just sitting there. What a miracle it is that in the night pitch dark amavasya, I step out and say, there is nothing. Nothing exists. In the bright daylight, then in the same morning, a few hours later, I say, oh, wow, look at all that. The green grass and the rainbow and the clouds and the bird. There's everything. And there's nothing. And there's everything. And there's nothing. It was the same. The difference was light or darkness. So this light will start to show you where those paths are, how to save yourself from it. Rag roop rajo gun ko kamana aur asakti se utpanna jaan, vah is jivatma ko karmon ke aur unke phal ke sambandh se bandhta hai. Sab rago rajo ragatmakam viddhi trishnat sanga samudbhavam tanni badhnati kaunteya karma sangeen dehnam. The one that compels us to do anything, this sideways fan that's blowing. And so if you're clever, when this fan is blowing this way, you'll go to the other side. And the fan starts to blow this way, you'll figure out a path to go on this side. Sometimes you might get caught in it. You may end up going to some event and eating something you didn't want to eat or say something that you did not mean. But on occasion, you might get caught up. But as you are, if you're careful, if you're watchful, you will be able to figure yourself out around it. And there might be a path that you find that is taking you upward, for example. तो बुद्धिमानी से अगर देखिए वो सबसे बड़ी बात अपना अपनी जिद छोड़े तो राजस कैसे बैठता है राजस चिपकता है कैसे राजस जब हम में आता है तो इसका पहला लक्षण क्या होता है जिद हट अटक स्टबर्ननेस बीइंग स्टक इज द फर्स्ट श्योरेस्ट साइन ऑफ राजस इट हैज एंटर्ड माय हेड आई फीलिंग स्टक इन दिस नो 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 आई हैव टू दिस हैज टू हैपन If not this way, then that way. So unstuck, kare. Gunon se agar chutna to unstuck, fluid. Tabhi to jab opportunity milegi to upar uth jayenge. Stuck hoge to udhar hi lathadte rahenge. So becoming unstuck is imperative on this path, which means becoming as open-minded as possible. Ultimately, we'll see that even if you get all sattvic. Go above the fan that's blowing the air below. Still, there is the glass ceiling. We're still stuck. We're still in the box. That's still not it. Because it's a matter of time before we get again caught up in the wind. And here we go again. But the path out to escape is from the ceiling. The holes in the ceiling or the path or however you want to imagine is from the ceiling, not from the sidewall, certainly not from the floor. And so sooner or later, if you manage to stick at the ceiling level above the fan that is blowing the air, then it's a matter of time before you're going to find your hole and escape nirguna. The last six shlokas of this chapter are super packed, super powerful, because in it he describes, so what is the person who has escaped? Arjuna asks, is it even possible? Does it happen? And if so, the person who manages to escape to this glass box, not being tossed and turned anymore, truly free. What are the characteristics of that person? How can we tell that this person is actually living outside the box? And he described in the last, I think, six verses of this chapter. But the chapter builds up, by the way. This is, I am milking it, I'm belaboring it to squeeze every bit out of it. Like in, it is so quote, it, what I love about it, it really cumulatively builds up the power of this chapter. So so far he has shown us the sattvic and rajasic, what to watch for, kamana or asakti, trishna sanga samudbhavam. To be exact about what Krishna is saying, trishna or sanga. Sanga means obsession. Chipakna, this means when it's stuck. Kaha. Yeah, we want someone's company. I can't live without this person. Oh, yeah, they've left. It's been a week. I hope they're okay. Constant the gravity of the mind, constantly gravitating towards material objects, relationships, all related to matter. Obsessed. Compulsive, obsessive behavior or OCD. That is one. Saying that's a clear sign. Everybody is obsessed about something or someone. Everybody, we all act compulsively until we are able to rise above it. So no one should say that, oh, I know one person with OCD, this person has this, that. I'm talking about all of us here. So that's one sign. And then second is trishna. Trishna is this yearning, longing, thirst, please. I wish I will get this. I wish aisa ho jaye. I wish ye promotion ho jaye, ye case jeet jaye, ye bach jaye, hamare mar na jaye, ye aisa na ho jaye, waisa na ho jaye, to ye ho jaye, wo ho jaye. Ye trishna bahut deep, bahut prarthana, bahut aarti, bahut minnate, bahut teerth yatra, bahut daan dharma, bahut kuch bhi karke sab anushthan, bahut phere 108 ke 108 aisa ho jaye, aisa na ho, aisa ho jaye. Ye trishna isko bura ka hai, galat ka hai, wrong, bad. If it has to do with matter, it's the sideways fan. Trishna or sangha, obsession and yearning, longing. Shivami, one trishna for Krishna. Otherwise, this fan has putreshna, vitteshna, and lokeshna. तीन स्पीड रहते हैं ना, जैसे वो पंखे उषा का पंखा लगा था इंडिया में, वो जो भी सिंगर का उषा का एक स्पीड, टू स्पीड, थ्री स्पीड, वैसे पुथ्रेष्णा, वित्तेष्णा, लोकेष्णा इसके है. एष्णा इज दिस थर्स्ट, पुत्र एष्णा, माय प्रोजेनी, माय सन, माय डॉटर, विच स्कूल, विच डिग्री, विच जॉब, व्हाट सैलरी, वेयर डू दे लिव, व्हाट डू दे डू, व्हेन आर दे प्रमोटेड, हाउ अबाउट देयर चिल्ड्रन, where all that, extended parivar, that's putra ishna, putra ishna, that's speed number one. Oh, to dusra, vitte ishna, with, has two connotations, knowledge and money, wealth. Wealth is primarily, predominantly understood as wealth, opulence, more, ishna is taking us to. Well, not satisfied, this is not enough, because if I only have this, then my child can go out of state, maybe they can go overseas, or I don't have to worry about this. I would have a house here and there, then I can go wherever, or I can maybe able to leave this much for my, or maybe what about my alumni association, my school, my ashram, my guru, my this and that, whatever sugarcoating, but therefore I must earn more. I must have more. Vitteshna. And the second kind of with is also knowledge. Eshna. Well, now this, I want to know about this. I'm constantly surfing is vitteshna. Constantly surfing that and forwarding, surfing and forwarding and surfing and forwarding. Because I want to know and I want to spread that. The jokes and this whatever weird thing happened, this, that, constantly. No. Should be saying no. That's with teshna, putreshna, with teshna. And the third, number three, so pangeko jala, lokeshna, fame and fortune. Mera naam to mandir pe party pe laga rahe, logon ko pata chale mere mai company ka president hu, kisi ko ye mere bacche ko PhD mil rahi hai, kisi ko aur kidhar mere tau ne aisa kiya tha, waisa kiya tha, hamare gaon mein ye hota tha. Lokeshna, prasiddhi ho, name and fame and fortune. Putreshna, vitteshna, lokeshna, that is eshna. And the thirst for those is trishna. Replacing trishna with krishna is the solution for it. He'll give me however much I need. Whatever he gives is perfect for me. Cannot be anything other than perfect. A little more than that can be imperfect. And a little less will be suboptimal. And therefore, because he's the perfect, however he's kept me with is only perfect. That's being with Krishna, not just bhajan, dhamadam, bajate re, laddu pede karte re. Internally being with Krishna, never leaving him in every action, in every thought, in every speech, in every deed. Never without him. Forget American Express. Never leaving him. That's Krishna. So Raj is sejer chutti pai chahiye ho. Ye wale pankhe se rajogun se. To Krishna ko pheko, Krishna ko apnao. Aur rajasik gun ka usne kya bata? Nirmalatvat prakash. Nirmal hai aur prakash hai. Tino gunon ke do characteristics bata. The top two characteristics of all three. सत्वगुण का क्या निर्मल है, प्योर, प्योरिटी, मल नहीं है, निर्मल अर्थात प्योर, और प्रकाशत्व एनलाइटनिंग है, दैट विच एनेबल्स मी टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो अंदर में जाके देख प्योरिटी, अगर सात्विकता में जाना, ऊपर उठना है तो अपनी प्योरिटी लाए, अपने मन में प्योरिटी, अपने वाणी में प्योरिटी, अपने आचार में प्योरिटी. मन के विचार, वाणी के उच्चार और तन का आचार, तीनों में शुद्धि लाए, प्यूरिटी अर्थात इम्प्यूरिटी निकाल दे. सबसे बड़ी इम्प्यूरिटी क्या है? स्वार्थ. स्वार्थ, सब मेन स्वार्थ कहां से आता है? अहंकार, अहम भाव, अपनापन. अहम क्या है? अपने आप को शरीर मान लिए, फिर से उधर ही आ गए. अपने आप को शरीर माना तो अपने को लिमिटेड समझ लिया, शरीर हो गया तो लिमिटेड हो गया, शरीर जब छूट, शरीर नहीं छूटा तो अनलिमिटेड हो गया. बदली वेव लहर टूट गई, लिमिटेड थी टूट गई तो अनलिमिटेड ओशन बन गई। बादल बदली बदरिया उसमें से हवा निकल गई तो पूर्ण आकाश बन गई। उतने समय से नाम रूप लेकर के सी तो अपने को शरीर मान लिया, लिमिटेड मान लिया, तो फिर इसमें अहम भाव आ गया, तो फिर स्वार्थ आ गया। स्व अर्थ मेरे को चाहिए, व्हाट्स इन इट फॉर मी, स्वार्थ इज विफम, मेरे को क्या चाहिए, मेरे को क्या चाहिए, मेरे लिए क्या, व्हाट अबाउट मी, व्हाट लाइक लिसन टू मी, ट्रस्ट मी, व्हाट अबाउट मी, डिड आई टेल यू, आई टोल्ड यू सो, मी मी मी, दैट इज इम्प्यूरिटी, दैट इज कंटेमिनेशन, दैट इज मेसिंग इट अप। My real nature is pure, ever pure, always pure, born pure, still pure, living pure, in death also pure. You know, impurity jabardasti upar se dal di, main mera tu tera ki. To mal aa gaya usme, satvikta ke dil se nirmal. Matlab niswarth, unselfish banati hai. Theek hai, humko mila jitna chahiye tha, humko bhi mil jaye, thoda sharing. Become sharing, caring, and daring through sattvikta. First, we start sharing. Just normal, naturally sharing. The more we start sharing, somewhere inside, because the nurture is already there, we turn out to be caring. Not just sharing, but making sure, do you have enough? Is that okay? Are you fine? Are you okay? Can I do something? Would you like more? Sharing, caring. उसी से फिर ये इधर छलांग लगाने का डेयरिंग आएगा सात्विकता से ही। सो सात्विकता के निर्मल और प्रकाश, राजसिकता के तृष्णा और संग ऑब्सेशन, किधर भी ऑब्सेशन है तो धड़ा से फेंक देना उसको, फाड़ के डर जाना से, रे तो दुश्मन आ गया। किसी भी व्यक्ति का, किसी भी वस्तु का, किसी भी परिस्थिति का, किसी भी इधर ही जाना है, देश का, काल का, उस समय का, इस समय का, वो जैसे आ गया ना दुश्मन आ गया, फाड़ के फेंक दे, नहीं उसके उल्टा करना बिल्कुल, अगर राजसिकता से छुटना हो तो। और इसका क्या बताया, प्रमाद और आलस्य, तामसिकता का, सब देह अभिमानियों को मोहित करने वाले तमोगुण को तो अज्ञान से उत्पन्न जान, वह इस जीवात्मा को प्रमाद आलस्य निद्रा, इसके तीन चार बताया भगवान ने, प्रमाद आलस्य निद्रा वेस्तन निबध्नाति भारत। इसके लक्षण चार है, अज्ञान है, अंधकार है, समझता नहीं है, डल है, क्योंकि इच्छा नहीं है, इच्छा नहीं है क्योंकि इच्छा दूसरे ओर चली गई, राजसिकता में इच्छा ही है, धन वैभव में इच्छा है, इसलिए इधर इच्छा नहीं है, सात्विकता में जो जितना भी था वो सब ऑब्सेशन ने दे दिया उधर, जितनी भी इच्छा थी, शक्ति थी, संकल्प शक्ति थी, जो भी अपना प्रभाव था, जो भी करने का कर्तृत्व था, वो सब उधर डाल दिया, इन्वेस्टर है वो, पोर्टफोलियो में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं ना, अग्रेसिव, सुपर अग्रेसिव पोर्टफोलियो में इन्वेस्ट किया, स्टॉक्स ही स्टॉक, इक्विटी इक्विटी, टेकिंग रिस्क, चांसेस, आई वांट टू ग्रो माय पोर्टफोलियो अग्रेसिवली, 100% इक्विटी, और वो उतना नहीं ऑब्सेस नहीं होगा, अग्रेसिव नहीं होगा, तो देन यू विल ब्रिंग बैलेंस टू द पोर्टफोलियो, कुछ बॉन्ड, कुछ कैश, कुछ ये वो, कुछ इक्विटी, कुछ उसमें भी अलग अलग प्रकार के, तो ऑब्सेशन इज दैट काइंड, सब उसमें डाल दिया, जिधर जो चाहिए उसके पीछे, उसी को उठा के इधर रखा भगवान ने, ऑब्सेस्ड अबाउट कृष्णा, जैसे मैंने कहा तृष्णा, तो कृष्णा की नहीं बस, सब बाकी सब छोड़ने को तैयार है, ये चाहिए ही अब बचे समय में। तो ये अंधकार तमोगुण का क्या, अंधकार प्रमाद, वेस्टफुल, थॉटलेसली वेस्टफुल, वेस्टफुल, आई हेट दिस गुण जब दिखाई देता है, तो प्रमाद का जो है, आई कैन नॉट इवन एडिक्वेटली डिस्क्राइब इट, thoughtlessly wasteful, like oblivious, ignorant, idiots, जिसे कहे कि इतना, जैसे कभी देखोगे पानी चल रहा हो तो clean water, because if you know what it takes to have the clean water that we have in America, I know because I've studied it for my master's in environmental engineering tech, and actually my first job in India was that water desalination also, as a chemical engineer. It takes immense energy and resources to have clean water like we do in America. And it hurts me deeply. It pinches my heart when I see people just, oh, beh raha hai, oh, dho rahe hai, cup, इधर उधर देख रहे हैं, बातें कर रहे हैं, कप उसके नीचे भी नहीं है, कप को तो दो दो चार बूंद पानी चाहिए, धर 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 बद 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 क्लीन वाटर बह रहा है उधर से. दैट इज माइंडलेसली वेस्टफुल, थॉटलेस, दैट्स प्रमाद. And they'll pay for that because it's just unacceptably wasteful. As one example, like lights, chale jaate din raat light chal raha, light hi light chal raha, kitu pata bhi nahi light chal raha. Gaadi chal rahi on diesel, gasoline, AC chal raha, khud bahar gapet ho gaya, chal koi zarurat nahi, fir chal rahi hai. Hours together, dekhne ko aate hai. Ye aaye tamasikta hai. And then when the people run out and you don't have, then you need more. Then फिर बैग बारो स्टील गलत रास्ते फिर से जाने के लिए. एंड सो देयरफॉर शुचिर दक्ष भगवान कहते हैं अनपेक्षा शुचिर दक्ष उदासीनो गतव्यथा सर्वारंभ परित्यागी यो मदभक्त समय प्रिय. माय डिवोटी अर्जुन इज नेवर लाइक दैट. इट्स नॉट वेस्टफुल, नॉट थॉटलेस, नॉट माइंडलेस. दैट इज द ऑपोजिट, शी इज द ऑपोजिट. अनपेक्षा, unexpected, expectation free, zero expectation level pe operate hoti hai meri devotee. Zero expectation level, zero complaint level. Imagine the state of mind, that how calm and beautiful and lovely that heart will feel inside when operating at a zero complaint level, zero expectation level. That's anapeksha. Shuchir daksha, shuchir is clean, pure. Not participating in impurity, not indulging under any influence. Daksha is alert, careful, watchful, thoughtful, not wasting time and gas and money and water and all that resources. Udasina gatavyata, a little elevated above. Udasina is above all this mundane give and take. And therefore, gatavyata, therefore rid of misery, never anxious, because get rid of all of these. Sarva arambha parityagi, this also contributes to the answer to Ashwini Bhai's question. Like I said, there are several, the answer pervades through, that's a $1 million question, like I told you the other day. The answer pervades through the entire Gita. Sarva arambha parityagi, someone who starts whatever they're doing, motive free, no intention. Just caring about it because it's there to be done. Not stressed out. Aarambh hi nahi kiya to khatam karenge. Jo chal raha hai to chal raha hai. Jitna first class kare, kaam apni usse first class. Not second class. Never third class. Always first class. If I'm going to do it, it will be first class. Should be the promise. And do only what that needs to be done, that is necessary. If it's not necessary, if it doesn't need to be done, I'm not going to do it. If I'm going to do it, it's going to be first class, always, without exception. That's Shuchir Daksha, Sarva Arambha Parityagi, motive free. I am not expecting anything out of this. I haven't started it with some sort of a motive, some sort of a sankalpa, some Sarva Sankalpa Sannyasi, sixth chapter, Dhyan Yoga, Yoga Arudastadochate. Arjun truly climbed on the horse of yoga, riding in control, is the one who has thrown far all the sankalpa. Sankalpa is not glorified in the Gita. Sankalpa mein vikalpa bhi aayega. Sankalpa vikalpa mein rajasikta aajayegi. Gita takes beyond the trigun through this chapter. Motive free, but always first class. That's a yogi. Like Krishna, the greatest example, Krishna, Ram, no motive, personal motive. Oh, weapon bhi nahi uthaega, jisko jitna hai jisko. Lekin ye vidhi likhi, vidhi ka vidhan hai. Nature is set in it. Yato dharma tato Krishna, or yato Krishna tato jaya. It's inevitable that Krishna will always be found with nature, dharma. That which is naturally designed, that which is naturally implanted, that which is naturally planned in it. The original, जैसे मैं शुरू में ध्यान के समय इस सत्र के पहले कह रहा था, आग का धर्म गर्मी है, जल का धर्म बहना है, बर्फ का धर्म ठंडा ही है, पृथ्वी का धर्म जड़ता है, प्रकाश का धर्म फैलाना है, ये उनके धर्म है। वो कोई हिंदू धर्म वाले प्रकाश, क्रिश्चियन धर्म वाले आकाश, ऐसा नहीं है। आकाश का धर्म धारण करना है, एक्सपैंडिंग, जिस आकाश का धर्म जिस जितना भी है वो सबको जगा दे। एक ही धर्म, पंच महाभूतों का हर एक का अपना अपना एक एक धर्म है बस। पृथ्वी का धर्म एक ही धर्म, सॉलिड उनके आधार देना, होल्डिंग, अप होल्डिंग, लेटिंग इट सिट ऑन इट, व्हाटएवर इज द धर्म ऑफ द पृथ्वी। पृथ्वी से जो भी बना सॉलिड, ये सॉलिड है फोन, तो इस पर अगर मैं किसी को इससे छोटे को रख दूं तो इधर ही पड़ा रहेगा। इसकी कोई मजाल नहीं है कि ये इसके नीचे गिर जाए, क्योंकि ये बड़ा जो उससे है, गुरु जो है उससे, उसका धर्म है कि कुछ भी हो जाए इसको पकड़ के रखना। विल नेवर कॉम्प्रोमाइज, जब तक ये इससे इतना भी बड़ा है, एक मिलीग्राम भी बड़ा है तो इसके ऊपर रखा तो ये अपने धर्म से कभी नहीं छूटेगा। और जब मोमेंट इससे बड़ा हो गया तो फिर उसका धर्म नहीं है, फिर वो इसका धर्म हो जाएगा। इसको पकड़ना, पृथ्वी का जो धर्म है, पृथ्वी ने चंद्रमा को पकड़ के रखा है, क्योंकि पृथ्वी खुद चंद्रमा से बड़ी है। जब पृथ्वी से सूर्य बड़ा है तो वो पृथ्वी सूर्य को नहीं पकड़ के, पृथ्वी उसके अराउंड घूम रही है। वैसे तो गुरुत्व जो है उसका, जल का धर्म है बहना बस, और कुछ नहीं करना उसको, अपने धर्म है। और तो अपने धर्म में तो कितने फर्स्ट क्लास रहे, कोई मर नहीं रहा, ना जल मर रहा, ना पृथ्वी मर रही, सब अपने धर्म में फर्स्ट क्लास रह रहे, सबका उनका नियंता संभाल रहा है। वो छोड़ दिया तो बहने लग जाए जल। ऐसे अपने अपने हर एक के आकाश का धर्म, जैसे मैंने कहा, बस जगह देना, कोई उसको कोई कंप्लेन ही नहीं है। कितनी इमारतें बनाओ, कितना बड़ा ऑफिस बनाओ, कितनी और ये मेरा अपना झंडा गाड़ दो, ये अमेरिका है, ये इधर है, और ग्रह और टुकड़े जो और सैटेलाइट भेज दो ऊपर, कोई उसको चिंता नहीं। महाशय को सबको जगा दे, एवर एक्सपैंडिंग द यूनिवर्स इज एवर एक्सपैंडिंग, द बिग बैंग इज एवर एक्सपैंडिंग बिकॉज इट्स नेचर। तो इसको धर्म कहते हैं। इसके बाद धर्म को कभी अपनी खोपड़ी में लाना ही नहीं, हिंदू धर्म, क्रिश्चियन धर्म, मुसलमान धर्म, कोई कभी, ये गलत, कहीं से गलती आ गई। ओरिजिनल नेचर, द डिजाइन, द इंट्रेंसिक क्वालिटीज इज धर्म। ऐसा हमारा इंट्रेंसिक धर्म क्वालिटी है हमेशा रहना, अस्तित्व, एवर एग्जिस्टिंग। देयर इज नो वे टू गेट रिड ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस फ्रॉम मी, जैसे देयर इज नो वे टू गेट रिड ऑफ स्पेस फ्रॉम स्पेस। स्पेस, रन आउट ऑफ स्पेस इज नॉट पास कंसीवेबल। कहा ये बहुत क्राउड हो गया, जगह नहीं रही। ऐसे ही मेरा, मैं कभी अस्तित्व नहीं रहूंगा। चेतन, चैतन्य एन आनंद, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल दैट आई एम नॉट हैप्पी इन माई ओरिजिनल नेचर, फॉर आई एम जॉय। ये पहचानना, ये उसके ऊपर निकल, ये ग्लास बॉक्स के जो ऊपर निकल गया एकदम, जो वो देख के अनुभव करने का, ओ माई गॉड, what was this, where was I stuck, what was this delusion, what was this maya, what was this make-believe world, what was I thinking, how, what a fool I was thinking I've got to get this and this and that and more. I was stuck like in a rut, like that frog in the well, thinking this is all there is to it. Now that I'm out of it, oh my god, कुछ नहीं, इधर मिला तो भी रहेगा नहीं, और जितना चाहिए उतना मिला है, तो कुछ मिलाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है। जितने प्रारब्ध में, जितना पहले से कमा के रखा है, मिलेगा ही, उससे ज्यादा नहीं मिलेगा, ये भी लिख के रखा है। कितना भी प्रयास किया, हम लोग प्रयास करते हैं, मिलता है और मिलता है छूट जाता है, नुकसान हो जाता है, कभी कभी और ज्यादा नुकसान हो जाता है, पहले से ज्यादा कमा देते हैं, नहीं मिलने वाला। प्रयास करें अपनी ओर से, कंट्रीब्यूटिंग नॉट कंज्यूमिंग, ऑलवेज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग मोर देन कंज्यूमिंग to the ecosystem around us. Watchfully, am I contributing more than I'm consuming? किसी के घर में गए, किसी रेस्टोरेंट में गए, मंदिर में गए, हम कहीं भी, किसी का समय ले रहे, किसी कुछ पूछा, किसी ने कुछ दिया, कंज्यूम किया, did I contribute more than I consumed? If I did not, then I was under the tamasic influence, I'm falling down. Come begging, borrowing, stealing. I'm consuming more than I'm contributing. If I'm contributing more than I'm consuming, then this wind has picked me up. That my mood, my attitude, my tendency, my inclination is to give more than take. to contribute more than consume, which is to rise above the moon? Or am I just constantly, it doesn't matter consuming, contributing, even if I'm consuming, it is to grow. Even if I'm contributing, it is to grow. Chalu banagar ke motive se selfishly daan de rahe, check likh rahe, contacts par rahe, why? घर जाके दरवाजा पे दो बिकॉज़ वो उनसे कांटेक्ट रहेगा तो बाद में जब अपना समय आएगा तो वो सिफारिश कर देंगे तो इधर प्रमोशन हो जाएगा बच्चे का जो भी तो या आई एम कंट्रीब्यूटिंग बट विद दिस क्लियर इंटेंशन ऑफ बिगर कंजम्पशन इन द फ्यूचर वेदर आई एम कंट्रीब्यूटिंग मोर और कंज्यूमिंग मोर इफ इट इज सेल्फिशली ड्रिवन देन आई एम इन कॉट अप इन दिस साइडवेज विंड तो ये सूक्ष्मता से अगर देखे ध्यान से विचार करें शब्द ही ध्यान है ध्यान करना पड़ेगा केयरफुली अटेंटिवली प्रोसेस करते ये दिखाई देने लगता है वी कैन डिसर्न दीज स्ट्रीम्स ऑफ वेरियस विंड्स विद इन अस देयर इज नो ग्लास बॉक्स दैट आई कंकॉक्टेड वी आवर माइंड वी शुड वॉच लाइक बीइंग फ्रॉम आई एम आउटसाइड द ग्लास बॉक्स यू आर आउटसाइड द ग्लास बॉक्स The mind is the glass box and all the sansara, all the maya is inside it. Last time maine kaha tha, yogi or sannyasi, maybe we'll do this and start wrapping up today's session. Kai baar ho chuke baad, yogi or sannyasi mein farak Bhagavad Gita mein kehte hai, sannyasi mat ban, kehte yogi ban. Kai jagah spasht kehte hai, sannyas ko achha kaha hai, bura nahi kaha. लेकिन उस झंझट में मत पड़ तस्माद योगी भवार्जुन तपस्वी भयो योगी ध्यानेभ्यश्च अधिको योगी कर्मेभ्यश्च अधिको योगी तस्माद योगी भवार्जुन सी दिस वाज द सेकंड फ्रॉम द लास्ट श्लोक ऑफ द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर एंड देन इफ यू गेट द थर्ड श्लोक फ्रॉम द फिफ्थ चैप्टर ज्ञेयस्य नित्य संन्यासी यो न द्वेष्टि न कांक्षति निर्द्वन्द्वो हि महाबाहो सुखं बन्धात्मुच्यते तेरे को अलग से संन्यास करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी However you live, wherever you live, whoever you live with in future, you will be a forever sannyasi. And the main difference is the sannyasi is the one who leaves the surroundings and everything in it to go find some place somewhere else that is superior and better than the people that he or she lives with or the place or the circumstance. सबको छोड़ के चले जाना और योगी बराबर उसकी एग्जैक्ट उल्टा करे जिधर रखा जिसके साथ रखा जैसे रखा जिस परिस्थिति में उधर से कहीं न जाए लेकिन ये देखे ये सब छूट रहा है सन्यासी ने खुद छोड़ के गया योगी खुद नहीं गया ये समझे ये सब छूट रहा है रिश्ते नाते पैसा धन देह छाड़ी छाड़ी सब जाता है देह गेह धन राज तो जो छूट रहा है उनको छूटने जो दे लेकिन खुद उधर ही रहे और सबकी सेवा करे जाते जाते और किसी को कुछ खिला दे जाते जाते सब सबको अपनी ओर से इतना आनंद छोड़ रहे हैं बच्चे जा रहे हैं घर जा रहा है नौकरी जा रही है माँ चली गई पिताजी चले गए जिसके जो भी मित्र चले गए सब जा रहे हैं जाने के लिए इधर ये मृत्यु लोक है जाना ही इधर जाना ही इधर डिफॉल्ट सेटिंग है इसके धर्म मृत्यु लोक का धर्म है नाउ यू नो व्हाट धर्म मींस जाना निकल जाना वैनिशिंग सो योगी डज नॉट गो एनीवेयर योगी इज वेयरएवर द योगी इज एट वर्क इन द शॉप अपने घर में अपने वालों के साथ दूसरे वालों के साथ फर्स्ट क्लास बिंदास ऑलवेज But never missing the point that everything is leaving me and I'm okay with it. It's okay. It's okay. You can leave. Not trying to hold on to it. Not trying to grab it. So that's a 180 degree difference between a sannyasi and a yogi, according to the Gita. So the one who has risen above. So last time when I had said, just to refresh memory and to bring up for those who were not here last time, was... There is a misconception, we should debunk it, and then we should wrap this up. And we'll take up next time from here on. कि संसार को छोड़ना है, संसार को छोड़ना है, संसार से छुट्टी का, संसार बुरा है, संसार संसार दो प्रकार के होते हैं, ये कभी किसी ने समझा नहीं, जाना नहीं है ठीक से। एक बाहर वाला संसार है जो आंखों से दिखता है, कानों से सुनते हैं, बाहर से उठा के खाते हैं, अंदर में डालते हैं, स्पर्श करते हैं, और एक अंदर वाला संसार है। बाहर वाले संसार को ग्रहण करने के बाद अंदर जो खलबली मचती है अंतःकरण में, मन बुद्धि चित्त अहंकार वाले अंतःकरण चतुष्टी में, वो एक संसार है। एक बाहर वाला संसार, एक अंदर वाला संसार। जैसे हम वेकफुल अभी जागृत अवस्था में देख रहे, सब अनुभव कर रहे, सुन रहे, सपने में भी सुनते हैं, सपने में बिल्कुल आवाज आती है, वी कैन स्मेल, वी कैन हियर, वी कैन टच, वी कैन सी, वी कैन फील एवरीथिंग। ऐसे ही जागृत अवस्था में भी अभी चल रहा है, बाहर वाला संसार चल रहा है और भीतर वाला भी संसार चल रहा है। तो जो द्वैतवादी है, भक्ति मार्ग के है मेरे जैसे, वो इसके ये नहीं कहते बाहर वाला बेकार है, संसार सच्चा नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है, माया है, एकदम फालतू है, इसे छूटो, झूठा है। नहीं, ऐसा नहीं। आखिर बनाया अगर भगवान ने, जिसने किसने भी बनाया होगा, भगवान का अगर सपना है, झूठे ने बनाया होता तो झूठा था, लेकिन वो तो परम सत्य है। सत्य ने बनाया तो झूठा कैसे हो सकता है। ये वाला संसार झूठा नहीं है, इसकी तो सेवा जरूर करनी है, इसको भगवान समझ के संसार की सेवा करनी है। इसे भगवान से कुछ कम नहीं है, भगवान ही है, एक ही है। तो उत्कृष्ट, फर्स्ट क्लास, जितनी बढ़िया हो सके उतनी सेवा करें। इसके कारण जो अंदर में संसार जागृत होता है, ऐसा है, वैसा है, ये नहीं हो, वो नहीं हो, ये चाहिए, वो चाहिए, ये क्यों हो गया, वो क्यों हो गया, और इतना और उतना, ये वाला झूठा है, उसका अस्तित्व तो नहीं है, बिकॉज इट इज मोमेंटरली कंकॉक्टेड, एंड दैट इज 99.9% ऑफ द संसार, द आउटर संसार। इतना सा संसार कितना देख पाते हैं हम लोग, कितने आंखों से, हमारा पेरिफेरल विजन है ही कितना, कानों से इतनी लिमिटेड बैंडविड्थ सुन पाते हैं हम, जितना सुन पाते उसके 10,000 टाइम्स ऊपर है, 10,000 टाइम्स नीचे है, इसकी वेवलेंथ जो हम सुन नहीं पाते। आंखों से जो सात रंग देख पाते हैं, इतने से स्पेक्ट्रम है, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ कलर्स अल्ट्रावायलेट, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ कलर्स इंफ्रारेड, ये तो ज्यादा संसार है ही नहीं। सेम थिंग, जितने भी टेस्ट वर्ड्स हमारे जीवा पे, उतनी टेस्ट हम डिसर्न कर पाते हैं, लेकिन टेस्ट कैन बी इनफाइनाइट। तो बाहर का संसार थोड़ा सा है, अंदर का संसार पूर्ण, पूरा सारा जीवन अंदर के संसार ने व्याप लिया है। ज्यादा से ज्यादा समय हमारे विचारों से, हमारे अंदर के संसार से हम ड्रिवन है, बाहर के संसार से लिमिटेड ड्रिवन होते हैं। ध्यान देके सोचना, देर आर लेस कंपल्शंस एंड लेस मैंडेट्स फ्रॉम द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड, करना ही पड़ेगा ऐसा जबरदस्ती एक आध बार कभी कभार होता, उसको अगर मानने की तैयारी, तो ये सारा कंपल्शन, सारा ऑब्सेशन, सारा जो बांध के रखा है, सारी कठिनाई जो है, सारी मुसीबत जो है, प्रॉब्लम पे प्रॉब्लम, सारे अंदर के संसार है, उसको छोड़ना है भैया। भगत अगर भगत वाले है तो भक्ति के मार्ग में, भक्ति के मार्ग में बाहर वाले संसार को अपनाना है, भगवान समझ के, भगवान का है, भगवान ही है, भगवान से बना है, भगवान ही उसका मटेरियल कॉज है, एक्चुअल बनने का जो पदार्थ है वो भगवान है, और बनाने वाला कॉजल कॉज भी वही है, जिसने बनाया वो भी भगवान, और जिससे बनाया वो भी भगवान। जैसे माँ ने बच्चे को बनाया, माँ ने अपने से बनाया और उसका उसमें आ गया, भगवान ने संसार को बनाया अपने से बनाया, लेकिन अपना हिस्सा लेके, विराट पुरुष ने his ingredients and the maker is him also, so complete in and out, there is no problem with the outer world for a yogi, for a sannyasi maybe, for a yogi there is never any problem with the outer world because the inner world is in control and it's called yoga root. All the problems are in the inner world, that is the one to be shunned, that is the one to be given up, that is the one to be ignored, neglected, spit upon and walked past. अंदर के संसार का कोई गिनना नहीं है, उसकी कोई मानना नहीं है, उसकी कोई सुनना नहीं है, अंदर के संसार की। बाहर के संसार के आगे तो प्रभु है, प्रभु में अखिल ब्रह्मांड मा एक तो श्री हरि, सब जग प्रभु मत, प्रभु मय देख ही, गीता में भी कितने जगह खुद भगवान ने खुद ने कहा, राम ने कहा रामायण में, कृष्ण ने कहा भागवत में, संतों ने कहा कृष्ण में कि नहीं 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 ये सब नहीं ही हूँ भगवान संसार। तो बाहर वाला संसार का त्याग नहीं करना है, अंदर वाले संसार वाला त्याग को, अंदर वाले संसार को रखना नहीं है, इसको त्यागना है और इसका त्याग नहीं करना है, इसको रहना है जैसा है वैसा रहने देना है। तो इसलिए कहा कि ये जो कांच का डब्बा है वो अंदर वाला, ये अंदर चल रहा है संसार, राजसिकता भी अंदर है, अंदर वो पंखा राजसिकता अंदर चल रहा है, तामसिकता भी अंदर है दबा रहा है, सात्विकता भी अंदर है उठा रहा है, ये तीनों से जो निकल जाओ पता चले कि ये तो मैं ऊपर से देख रहा था डब्बे में, मैं थोड़ी हूँ इसमें, मैं नहीं हूं इसमें, मेरे स्पर्श से मेरे मेरे एसोसिएशन से मेरे प्रभाव से थोड़े समय के लिए इस जड़ पदार्थ को अपना अपना गया, एग्जिस्टेंस जैसे लग गया, जैसे सूर्य का थोड़ा सा प्रकाश आया हाथ पे तो वार्मथ लग गई, वो ये गर्म नहीं हुआ लेकिन उसके एसोसिएशन से थोड़े समय के लिए दिखाई देने लगे, प्रकाश भी मिल गया और वार्मथ भी मिल गई, गुरुत्वाकर्षण भी गया, ऐसे ही मेरे संपर्क से इस चित्त को सत्यता एज इफ, सत्यता मतलब एज इफ इट एग्जिस्ट फॉर रियल, एज इफ इट डजंट, एज इफ इट एग्जिस्ट थ्रू एसोसिएशन, सत्यता आ गई, compelling, because my force is so indomitable of the Atma is that the mere association of it creates such a compelling effect that it feels so real inside that I must have it, I have to have it, this I cannot let this happen. Itna compelling ho jata through the association, satata. It feels, satya is also true, it feels real, feels true. नहीं तो उसका बाप मरा तो वो रो रहा है लेकिन दूसरे का मरा तो नहीं उसको कुछ नहीं लग रहा है, तो लगना चाहिए था, पिता पुत्र का नाता अगर टूट रहा है तो किसी को इसमें आनंद लग रहा है किसी को उसमें आनंद बिल्कुल नहीं लग रहा है, अगर सेम था तो सबको लगना चाहिए था, नहीं अपने अपने बक्से में अपन अपना अपना बना के रखा मसाला, हर एक का अपना अपना बक्से में, उधर जैसा लगे वैसा, तो उसको इग्नोर करना है, निग्लेक्ट करना है, डिसरिगार्ड करना है बाहर वाले संसार को नहीं। So with that, we will stop here. Next time, we'll pick up on number 9. Sattvagun sukh mein lagata hai, rajogun karma mein, aur tamogun gyan ko dhakkar pramad mein lagata hai. That's where we'll pick up. So we'll do a few minutes, 5 minutes of dhyan, and then spend a few minutes sharing with each other. And then that's it. And then there's a 5:30 Ganeshotsav session at the Udeshis in Gainesville also. So shortly, we'll join there. So, Jai Shri Krishna.